I forgot to switch it on the proper fucking, mic. Sorry about that, you guys. But at least I caught it sooner this time. So, we'll go ahead and I'll start reading this again. Jack, while you were in the hospital, a hunt was declared on all cops. It's like the criminals in the city suddenly went savage. They're cornering officers one by one and beating them to death. Cut.
Is that? No, not cut. Our boys. I don't know where I got cut from. Our boys have started refusing to ride out on calls alone when the situation is really bad. Even two will refuse to go. Oh, that's great.
And I got my raise. And I got my sheriff with automatic weapons. And we're going to take everything this time. And so we will hire an extra one for the A shift. And two for the B shift, I think. I think that's what we want. I think that's the... I can always switch them around. And then I can already ask for a new thing. And I think I'm going to ask for a new detective slot. Okay. Vandalism. A passerby saw three teenagers setting fire to a parked car, according to the eyewitness. You can still catch them. They're just walking down the street, not even in a hurry. So we're going to send two out. But anyway, I had just taken like a 20-minute break between recordings, but I had to unplug my mic, which is why things went kind of wonky. Oh, what's this? Ooh. Oh, and that's right, we have, this. So, since apparently no breaks in the case have been made, I'm gonna look up a solution real quick and see if I was just really off. So, I'm back, and I was fucking right. So, I guess the game just hasn't triggered. You'd think after I was in the fucking hospital for, what was it, 3 weeks? There would have been a fucking break in the case and more of these, but, you know, what the fuck ever. That's wrong. That's all wrong. And I hope they get more soon. All right. Wow, so many of my officers are tired. It was never like this when I was running the show. What the fuck did my deputy do? A security guard noticed a suspicious group of teenagers hiding things under their jackets as they walked past the checkout. When he asked them to stop, the teenagers scattered in all directions, then ran out of the store into the parking lot. The guard called the police and says they couldn't have gotten far. We'll send two. They're kids. And quite frankly, I'm not overly concerned with petty theft. Alright, so that's started. An unidentified woman says that a strange surgeon is operating without a license from the basement of her house. He hardly looks like a real doctor. He's old, maybe sterile, and always seems drunk. I highly doubt that he's practicing medicine without a license, but we'll send a couple just in case. Officers were on. I swear to God, every single one that girl is in, I think I might fire her. Because she fucking sucks. And it seems like everything that she's fucking in... Yeah, failed three assignments in a row. Yeah, I'm sorry. She's not doing anything. And everything that she's a part of seems to be a detriment to the fucking case. So we'll hire someone new and hope for the best. But, I mean, she fails things constantly. A student couldn't get into his room. It was locked from the inside, and he heard muffled cries coming from within. It sounded like someone was raping my girlfriend. I'm not entirely sure this is 100% needed, but we'll send a couple anyway. In a dirty basement, a teetering old man is digging around inside a young man's ripped open stomach. Oh shit, it's the real thing. This guy is fucking nuts. Okay, so rush the old man or the old man to slowly step away from the patient. Call a fucking ambulance. I'm okay with them not getting them because the welfare of the victim, I think, takes a bit more priority. Although he's now out. Just, I take responsibility for that one, though. I don't blame those guys. The girlfriend was having a special moment with her new boyfriend. Oh, shit. Poor guy. Alright. A nurse reports that she saw an elderly woman cut off her husband's life support system after a car accident left him in a coma for months. I know his case was hopeless, but it's all murder, the greatest sin of all. According to the nurse, the woman has blocked off the entrance to the ward. Well, if she actually is blocking off the entrance to the ward, that's not good. However, given that the elderly woman is cutting off life support to her husband, I'm not convinced that she's actually doing it illegally. She probably holds power of attorney, and her husband has been in that coma for months, so she is choosing to let him die. That is, and maybe she wanted to be the one to pull the plug for whatever reason. But I'm not convinced that it's super necessary. I don't even think it's necessary to have both of them go, but given the situation that the city explained at the beginning of this day, I'm going to go ahead and just send them off in pairs of twos from at least twos from now on. Alright, a trucker just called in. He says a van stopped on the side of the road. Sorry. And three large men got out with shovels. Then someone fell to the ground and out of the back of the van. I think they had his hands tied up. They hit him in the head with one of the shovels and led him into the woods. Yeah, that's... Let's see. We're going to send four, although now with her in there is probably going to fail, but we'll send the SWAT team. Get everyone. Oh, so it really was illegal? I just figured, that's interesting. So I find it interesting that Jack has had this sudden change in demeanor. I hope he divorces his wife, because she deserves it. Looks like we have a situation here. The van is empty, but the engine is still warm. The area is silent and dark. Turn on the flashlight and run into the woods. Wait and ambush them near the van. Now, they may not have killed the guy yet. Enter the forest, trying not to make any noise. 412. Yes. I still stand by firing that woman. She sucks. An eyewitness reports that five armed men burst into a jewelry store. A series of gunshots followed. Then, a few minutes later, a girl staggered out of the store, bleeding from the stomach. She fell onto the pavement unconscious. So, yeah, they're not going to get back in time. So we'll send all four of the cops that we have and hope that the next call that comes in can wait until everyone's back. Okay, so we have three, but that's not enough. So we'll wait. And now we have those four back, plus the SWAT team and the paddy wagon, so we should be good for any upcoming calls. We'll send two more. I'm really hoping I can get some jewelry, because that was some serious fucking cash. I need that cash, especially since a bunch of days went by. I don't have nearly enough money for this point in the game. I'm hoping that more opportunities come up to make more money, but all I have is 83,000 at the moment. So, good. Unharmed. Civilians unharmed. Yes! Jewelry. Mafia will sell it. Oh, I'm so excited! Alright, end of the day.
Impressive recovery, Mr. Boyd. I'm still not happy about how soon you're back to work. Well, not happy as your doctor. As a resident of Freiburg, I'm immensely grateful for it.
Really?
Just don't tell anyone, or they'll pull my license.
Well, thank you again for coming to see me at night.
Oh, well, whatever you need, Mr. Boyd. Any doctor in this town would come running any hour, day or night, you can believe me. You're not suffering from headaches. It says here that you are taking painkillers after a back injury. But the prescribed dose is enough to...
Dr. Kraczynski, you trust me?
And, sorry?
Do you trust me?
In what way, Mr. Boyd?
You think I'm an honest and reasonable man, Doctor?
You're joking, Mr. Boyd. Thanks to you, my wife finally agreed to buy a house here, and we've decided to have children. Thanks to you, I'm not afraid to visit my patients at night. I think you are the most honest and reasonable person in the city, Mr. Boyd.
Great. You see, Dr. Kraczynski, I'm an addict.
Mr. Boyd,
Well, not a drug addict in the way you might imagine. I'm not some weak-willed junkie. Sometimes I stay clean so long that the tablets stay locked in the barn so long they go past the expiration date. But there are less pleasant stories.
You know what?
I once took a whole bottle right there in the barn. Passed out in my own vomit. I almost choked. I fought the convulsions, somehow managed to break four ribs. For 2 weeks, my chest was so sore, I wanted to die. But for those 2 weeks, I kept swallowing pills. Couldn't stop.
If you want, I could...
I once took a dose right before a party at home. My wife Laura had some old friends over from college. I didn't take that many, maybe 5 or 6 pills, but it felt like I'd taken a few hundred. I passed out while I was carrying a tray of drinks. On the way down, I knocked over a set of Laura's scented candles. The house almost burned down. The repairs took a good chunk from our savings.
Mr. Boyd, if you'll allow me,
As you can see, Doctor, I'm well aware of the seriousness of the situation and the possible consequences. But sometimes I need the pills. I don't use the word lightly. Sometimes I've got to work on cases with more energy than I've got. I can't do it without them. And I know you want me doing my job. So tomorrow I want you to come here and bring me some tablets. Lots of tablets. 10 bottles. No, better 15. Yeah, 15 bottles. The next 3 months are going to be extremely difficult, Doc.
I would like to discuss your...
You'll bring the pills, Doctor?
Yes, Mr. Boyd. Yes.
Very good. Look, I don't want to trouble you any further. I bet your family doesn't like you running away with me at night. I bet they'd rather I was still in that coma.
Well, that was a very interesting cutscene. I'm not entirely sure what to make of it. Kevin Paulson, next Freeburg Police Chief. Kevin Paulson preparing to take helm at FPD. Mayor Rogers supports Kevin Paulson as next police chief. I trust my family. Austin didn't come to work today. Party didn't come to... What the fuck? There's a fire at my daughter's school. And my little girl was seriously burned. She's in intensive care. Yes. It's my dog's birthday and I want to spend... You can do it tomorrow. The dog doesn't know any different. It's up all night reading and exciting. No. Okay. Damn, those two didn't... I'm going to let them off the hook this once because I'm brand new back and it seems like a lot of my guys were overworked while I was gone. So... This isn't a bad cassette. See requests. Now I can hire one more detective. So let's go ahead and just hire new detective. It's kind of sad though, this song. Alright. Two teenagers were sitting on some steps and smoking. A black man approached and asked for a cigarette. Go ask somebody else. Monkey. Oh, shit. The adolescents responded. The man grew enraged, quickly pulled out a knife and drove it into the chest to one of the teens. According to the other teenager who managed to escape, then he took a cigarette, quietly sat down on the steps, and started smoking. Not saying what the kids did was right. I think it's fucking ridiculous that they would say that to him. That response, though, holy shit. I personally wouldn't mind so much if he had just, like, scared the kids. Yeah, scare the shit out of those kids. But, damn. Morse Queen heard from a neighboring apartment a panicked female voice cry out, "Help, I'm being raped." Then, according to him, all was quiet for a few seconds. Then I heard something about laundry and bleach. And then some music started playing. Okay. We'll send a couple of cops down there. I'm really sure it's not though. Damn. If those girls don't show up for another shift, I'm gonna have to fire them. Bender caught, officers unharmed, so we're good there. Electrician Jason Pruitt was conducting a regular inspection at a transformer substation and found a dirty hairy bum who pounced on him like a wild bear. The homeless man bit him pretty severely, ripping a piece of flesh from his hand. The electrician was stunned but managed to run away from the substation, leaving the suspect inside. Send a couple of cops there. And it turns out that Mr. Queen's neighbors had just bought a new TV and were watching some horror movies at full volume.